Okay, welcome to my craft room. Formerly, this was one of my kids' bedroom, but they are grown and gone, which is not a bad thing. Kids are not meant to live with you forever, so it's kind of nice that they are gone and they are doing well. So what I decided to do was to get myself a hobby. My husband and I used to hang out on a Saturday, but he got himself a hobby, so he left me home all alone. So I was whining and complaining to my sister one day, and she said, "Why don't you get yourself a hobby?" So I did. And it grew from 3 set of pliers to tons and tons of pliers. Pliers here, pliers there. Oh, and pliers everywhere. So needless to say, I have a set of pliers, well, several sets now. First of all, this is my, we'll start over here on the left. I look hard to try to display myself so I can see it and know what I have. I created this little board right here. I got myself some of that corkboard, and I cut it in half, and I got it all over the room, and I find myself hanging non-tarnished jewelry on these type boards, because if you hang a lot of silver and whatnot, it tends to tarnish because of whatever is in the air. And I bought this little stand here from Hobby Lobby, which was like a little gate, but I took it apart and I made two different little hanging parts right here. Kind of hang pieces of jewelry here. And I have scissors and headphones when I'm listening to music or something and my husband don't want to hear it because I tend to have it a little bit loud. And this is a station here that I have some empty slots here, but I'm quickly filling them up. I got this piece from the Hardware store. I got this piece right here from Joann's, which let me see, which has different little drawers, little pieces here that I use quite a bit, and I keep all my little beads in, and I actually put labels in the drawer once I'm out, and if I want to go back and purchase whatever item that was in there, it's just easy for me just to pull that information off. This is nice. It's really a nice, and this little set down here, this is kind of wobbly. The very bottom shelf, I need to replace it because I have all this other stuff sitting on top of it, which is much heavier, and it's kind of caving in, so I need to replace it. And of course, my trusty vacuum cleaner, which I use faithfully because sometimes that wire pops, and I have carpet on the floor. It's hardwood floor, but I have a piece of carpet on there, which I like to have carpet under my feet. So this is my closet here, and I use it as my closet with my clothes in it. And I also store some of my jewelry pieces and hangers up in here. These are pieces that I have, display boards that I hang my jewelry on when I'm doing my little craft fairs, which I'm really, really enjoying the craft fairs. And again, this is a piece of the Concordian jewelry holder that I took apart and I put stuff on it, and I just loved, and this is another corkboard that I cut, but it's a little bigger, and I love displaying my jewelry pieces. I love to touch it, feel it, rub it. It just, I just love that. And I bought this, I don't know what I'm gonna use it for, but excuse me, but I'm going to eventually use it. It just spoke to me. And I have the tubes over here, and I have all my little wires. I converted a clothes hanger and I put some of my wires on it. It's just easy to pull. And this shelf right here, let me pan back a little bit. My husband, I saw this in Essie's, and I drew a little sketch of what I wanted mine to be. And my husband, who is a carpenter, very good, very creative, he made that for me. And he actually drilled top holes where I can store some of my tools and my Rain Man drum and scissors and things. It just drops in there. And I have little hooks in here where I hang some additional wires and threads and whatnot. And of course, I have a basket here, and that basket contains a little thread. And some more of my tools are down here, and my Rain Man drum holder. Oh, and my sewing machines. I have two sewing machines. I have the little Singer sewing machine there, and I have this huge Singer. It's old, but it's good. It is fast. This machine sews to me 100 miles an hour. It just sew through a pair of blue jeans or corduroy, any thick material that you have. It will outdo this little Singer anytime. So I use both. And again, I have some storage over here. I have my jump rings, and I have crimps, and I actually try to color code them because, jump rings come in silver, and then you have the color jump rings, the silver jump rings, and gun metals and all that kind of stuff. Oh, and my husband also made this for me. I remember, let me see if I can pan out a little bit. I was hanging some jewelry because I had just glued it, and my husband, I was complaining. So I came up with that little sketch, and of course, he just went wild with it. It's kind of like a little clothesline, a little crossbar. I can glue my little pieces and just hang it on there, and it does really, really well. He's very creative. And I have my third arm, a second arm, third arm, third hand. But these little machines here, this little equipment here, I don't know if you can see it there, but they are really, really great. I love those. And what else I have here? Oh, and more storage. These are little storage here that I got from Walmart. I believe I got these from Walmart, and of course they are labeled. And I do believe in having flowers, something alive in your home. So I got flowers all over the house. So more storage and more flowers and whatnot. And these are just more storage, more beans that I got from Walmart. And this piece right here, I think I got it from Walmart as well, or the hardware store. And this is my little section here where I keep all my receipts and things once my beading come in, and you always get this huge, huge catalog from Fire Mountain Gym. And I said, my God, why would they send this huge thing? But I love it. I go in it, I look, I find things that I might want to order, or even something I give me an idea by creating things. But I save all my little billings and stuff here. I also have, my husband built this as well. Again, my jewelry displayed so I can touch it, feel it, look at it. I just do something to me. And let's see, I got my chains. I got chains over here. Is that out of focus a little bit? And my iron and board and iron. And over here, as I said, this is a bedroom. I need to get rid of this bed, but I just can't. For some reason, I just can't. If I did, it'd give me more space. So I just use it as a giant table right now. I have other little things in here. This storage, a shoebox that I got jewelry and stuff in it that I make and that I sell. And I also, one drawback about being you create jewelry, you have family members that think you are in the repair business. So these are some things, repairs that I've done to bracelets, earrings, and necklace that I have to send back to them. I've repaired them so I can send it back. Which I don't mind. I love doing things for my family. This is on my bed. I got more storage, more containers. I'm a member of the Bargain Bead of the Month Club, and I get all these beads and things, which is a wonderful club. I love it, love it, love it, love it. And I don't know what to do. I use it, and when I have extras, I don't know what to do with it just yet. I'm gonna come up with a way of storing it so I can see instead of just dumping it out on the bed and going through it. And my knotter, and my favorite in this whole entire room is this lamp. I don't know if you can see it, but this lamp is simply beautiful. I could not survive without it. My son and daughter-in-law purchased that for me when I think it was for my Christmas present. They asked me what I wanted, and I told them exactly what I wanted, and they got exactly what I asked for. So that was great job, kids. I love you for that. And over here, I don't know if you can see it, but I have another lamp. It's a, I don't know what kind of material it is, but I actually use it as a giant pin cushion. If I have loose change or chains, and I have my glasses here, protective glasses, and different little pieces that I have, and I just use it as a stick pin, and I put them up there. And this board right here, I just made that, and I'm gonna put my business cards, cards that I get from people, or little notes or things that I want to remember. And you can't do without a computer. You just got, I mean, it's just good to go on out there and you see what other folks are doing, and you get ideas and whatnot from them. And above all, my fan. You can't do without a fan, because when I'm in here illegally making jewelry or using that a torch, I love the torch. I love soldering. I'm into soldering now. But I turn that fan on and I'm thinking, okay, he's not going to smell that stuff. And he always smell it. Or to help ventilate the room when you're using that, is it E6000 or different type glues that you're using? And I have several different type hammers and whatnot. But let me show you my sorter. I just love this machine here, this little sorter here. It is really, I don't know if you can see it. I put it back down here. But it is fantastic. I use it quite a bit. I'm getting rather good at it. All right, so this is my craft room again. And oh, I forgot, I bought these tools. These are punchers, hole punchers. I'm trying to decorate my jewelry, make it more pretty. You know, people like pretty stuff. I like pretty food when I go out to a restaurant. If they display it pretty on my plate, you know, it's good to me. That's in my mind. But these are some tools that I have that I purchased, and they're great. They're big and bulky, but they do the job. They go through heavy paper and whatnot. And these are more tools that I have that I keep all my tools pretty much together, so I don't like to look all over the house for them. But again, like I said, this is the tour of my craft room. A little bit messy, but like I said, I really need to get rid of that bed so I can put more storage, and it would be better for me. So that is it. There are a little bit more, but I'm not going to show you the rest of that junk that I have. It's my good junk. Just love that junk. Alrighty, bye-bye.